Here we are.
Let's go.
Here we are. Let's go.
Here we are.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Hey, everybody. My name is Ty Cortez, and you're watching the Ty Cortez Show. Just let me know and what? Comment down below. So, you see, we have three very special guests here. My brother, and these are my two friends, and my brother's best friend that he's known for a very, very long time.
That's right.
So, what's your name?
Jack Bergeron.
What's yours?
Darren Souls.
Avon Gutez.
Yep, of course. And so how long you guys known each other for?
A long time.
Yeah, a long time.
A long
like
time.
Like, how old were you guys when you guys first met each other?
Probably like, I don't know, 7 or 8.
7 or 8?
Yep.
And how old are you guys now?
I'm 18. He's 18 too, and 17.
I'm 17.
Wow, so I'm 18, Jack's 18.
So you guys known each other for like 10 years.
Me and Jack are the
years.
Same age.
Yeah.
So you guys known each other for 8 years. That's crazy.
Me and Jack are the same age.
You get the same exact age. You guys are all in the same class, right?
Yeah.
So shout out to your school. What's your school?
New Bedford High.
Yeah, New Bedford High.
Show your shirts.
New Bedford Whalers.
New Bedford Whalers.
That's right. We represent our school.
So yeah. I heard a little something about Jack here. And he's trying to, and he loves basketball.
Yep.
Just like me. And he's trying to tell me Curry is the best player of all time. You think he's better than
and
Kyrie?
That is
I don't
true.
Know about that, though.
I don't know about that.
Who do you think is the best of all time?
Who knows? It could be both of them.
Michael Jordan is the best basketball player of all time.
Jack,
right now.
Jack, really? Huh? Are you
the
really
best kidding? In the world right now?
Curry,
who do you think?
I'm gonna go with both players.
Huh?
I'm gonna go with both.
Both?
Yeah.
Okay. What about you, Avon? Who do you think is the best of all time?
Steph Curry.
So obviously, if you like Steph Curry, your favorite team is the Golden State, right?
Yep.
Yeah. I knew it was that. I knew it.
Me too. Yeah.
Me too.
He knows them too.
Your favorites?
Huh?
Is it your favorite too, Golden State?
I don't care what team I like. I just like the teams.
I just like.
Yeah. No, right.
I just like teams.
So do you know a lot about Golden State?
Yeah, I know pretty much like everything.
So here's a little quiz, real quick. Are they going to the finals or not?
Well, they had a game last. Wait, it was the other night against Portland, and yep. Curry scored 36 mm-hmm. points.
I saw that game.
Yeah, and but that 3-point shot he made, he was like, we are going to the NBA finals.
Yep.
Our 7th NBA. Championship is now here
in a row, right?
Yep,
that's crazy. Do you think they're gonna win the finals though?
Yeah,
who do you think's gonna be versus them in the finals?
Well, if the Raptors
it's the
can
Milwaukee versus the Raptors right now, they're 2-2, right?
Yeah,
they both got
so
two
yeah, so they have two more games. If the Raptors win, they'll have one more game.
Yeah, sure.
If the Bucks win, they'll have one more game, and then it's either win or go home, and if the Bucks win, they're off to the finals. The Raptors win Kawhi versus Curry, and that's going to be a pretty good match up there.
Who do you think would be a tougher match for Golden State, the Bucks or the Raptors?
Oh, that one's kind of a tough one. I'll say the Bucks with...
The Bucks with Giannis.
Yeah.
You remember his last name?
Giannis...
Antetokounmpo.
Antetokounmpo.
Yep, Giannis Antetokounmpo. My favorite.
He's a beast there too.
He really is. He literally like he grew up in Greek and somehow he just made it to NBA. He's so good. He really is. He can shoot the 3-ball. He can lay up, rebound, dunk. He can do everything. So with you, I heard you like monster trucks.
Yep.
You like monster trucks. So who's your favorite monster truck driver?
All of them.
All of them. You like all of them.
Yeah.
You can't even pick. What's your favorite truck?
Grave Digger.
The Grave Digger? Do you watch like have you ever been to one of the Monster Jams or whatever?
Yes.
You have? How many?
I've been to one and this is my second one.
This is your second one? Are you going to be going to another one?
I don't know.
Do you hope though?
Yeah.
You said you wanted and we were talking in the car and you said you wanted another one. You wanted to buy a monster truck when you get older, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. What would you do if somebody just gave you the Grave Digger?
I'd drive it all around town.
You gotta go to school for that, though.
I know.
Do you think you could pass it?
Maybe.
Maybe?
Damn. Maybe.
What car do you want?
Either a BMW, a Lambo, or a Ferrari.
Ooh. Nice ones.
Yep.
Nice ones. Me, I would want a Lambo.
I would like a Rolls Royce.
The good thing is they are nice and fast, though.
They are.
I like Rolls Royce, though.
Rolls Royce?
Yeah.
Hey, you, Rick Ross got that, right?
Yeah.
So mm-hmm. I was saving this. So my brother, this is my brother right here, Avant. And he is one of the biggest WWE fans you'll ever meet. Oh, yeah. So tell me, who's your favorite WWE?
Ric Flair, John Cena.
Ric Flair, John Cena? I thought you'd like Big Show, though.
Me too. I like everyone.
You like everyone?
Yeah.
I like Roman Reigns.
You like Roman Reigns?
I like Roman Reigns.
I was watching WWE with Avant, and then my mom was like, who's that? And then I'm like, that's Roman Reigns. And my mom's like, he's cute.
Oh, so your mom was hitting on Roman Reigns.
Yeah. And then my dad was like, yep. What'd you say? And then my mom was like, I don't think
your dad was pretty too happy about
that. Nah, he wasn't happy at all.
Yeah. Now he has his shoulders up.
Lesnar, though, he's pretty good.
He's really good.
He's a beast.
Roman Reigns can get really hurt, though.
Yeah, he can.
Even though Roman Reigns is really good, he can really get like.
Wasn't he out from WWE for a while?
Yeah, he had some. I think he had cancer or something. One of those things. I don't know.
Leukemia.
Yeah, he had leukemia.
Yeah, leukemia. That's what it was.
Yeah.
But he was fighting like, mad long, like Superman punch.
Yeah, he was fighting mad people.
Yeah, mad people like Rusev and Big Show, everyone.
I know you watch like almost every single WrestleMania. Yeah. Can you tell me what WrestleMania it is right now?
WrestleMania 35.
It passed though.
It passed.
It already passed though, because you already watched it.
Yeah.
Do you like WWE too?
I haven't watched it.
Yeah, my favorite part was when Vince McMahon came out and said, "All right, guys, the first match here is for the Universal Championship, Brock Lesnar versus Seth Rollins."
And then Seth Rollins beat Brock Lesnar.
He did.
He low blowed him. Kicked him across that.
Do you think that was fair when he low blowed him?
I don't get why.
You think it was a cheap shot?
Probably a cheap shot.
Yeah, you think it's a cheap shot?
I don't get why Brock Lesnar would beat Roman Reigns in a steel cage match. I don't think that's a good match though. Even though Roman Reigns still won that match.
Like Roman Reigns touched the floor first before Brock Lesnar did.
I know.
Because the cage fell.
Yeah.
And then Brock Lesnar fell on the cage and They called Roman Reigns.
Yeah, and then time Brock Lesnar beat one for no reason. He didn't win.
Until though at SummerSlam, it was Brock versus Reigns.
And then Roman Reigns won.
Yep.
He did. Roman Reigns, I wanna say he's my favorite WWE character, but I feel like he's like up there in my top, like maybe top.
Why you like him?
My favorite WWE is Rey Mysterio. That's mine.
I like him too. He's small, but
he shows that he can beat anybody up.
I don't think he can beat anybody up when Roman Reigns is good with his Superman punch.
Have you seen Rey Mysterio's real face?
Have you seen Triple H's face?
His face is mad.
Yeah. I see Triple H face.
Oh,
he's wearing a mask.
Kane is the worst face you ever see.
He got burnt. He got burnt bad.
Yeah, he looks like his brother
Undertaker.
Yeah, his brother Undertaker. Those two, I like.
They're hard.
Did you see the part when Kane came out of the stage, and then when his brother came out, he was already back in the stage already.
I saw that.
Kane came back on the TV show and laughed at Kane.
Undertaker's
face because he left.
I know.
Did you see the part when Undertaker his real self when he had the red mask on, but when he died, yeah, when he took it off, he didn't have that mask and he was like human. Yeah, he was like human because he didn't have that red thing on his face. Yeah.
Because Roman Reigns beat Brock Lesnar
at
the WrestleMania 33.
Yeah.
And when Undertaker was like in a streak. Well, all this is a while ago though, and then Brock Lesnar beat it.
Did yeah, you see them? Did you see everybody the, was like, and, oh my god, the streak is now over now.
Yeah, everyone was shocked about what? Why did Undertaker won Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania?
I know.
And WrestleMania 32, Seth Rollins stole the WWE champion that Roman was trying to beat.
He cashed in though.
Yeah, he cashed
in. Adam Knight.
Yeah, he cashed in money in the big
who night. Who cashed in?
Seth Rollins.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you see the part when Steph Rollins got the thing and then Triple H was with him walking in from I guess the background of the stage and then he came and then I guess Brock Lesnar was standing there in the open and I guess someone hit him with a chair and
when someone hit the chair on him
and then he was on the floor like all hurt and stuff.
He was like hurt and he was like
yeah, money in the bank though.
Like he thought like someone was gonna come hit him from behind and he didn't. He looked back for one minute and then he got hit right in the back with a steel chair.
I kind of feel bad a little bit.
And it
was a hurt.
I feel bad when he got a low blow.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that hurt.
Yeah, I know.
What's your favorite like out of all of them? Would you like most interesting to you? Would you rather see it win a 1-2-1-2 a ladder match?
I like to see all of it.
Me, I want to see the triple threat match.
That's your favorite?
Yeah.
What's your favorite?
I do like the Royal Rumble, but if I had to choose though, it would be a triple threat with the three best superstars in WWE.
Who's those three best? Who would you put in that triple threat?
I will put Brock Lesnar, Braun Strowman, and Roman Reigns.
You think that's the top three right now?
Braun Strowman is bigger than all those. Braun Strowman, I don't know if Braun Strowman and Big Show would fight any other small wrestlers than they already are.
Yeah, but Braun Strowman and Big Show
I don't think they can be like Brock Lesnar, Roman Reigns, or
any of them,
because the only two big guys is Big Show and
Braun Strowman.
That's the only two big guys.
Isn't there a big cast?
Big Cass, but he got him hurt though.
Yeah, he got hurt though.
Yeah, so he's not technically there anymore.
Have you watched the money in the bank?
No, he didn't. But I seen it.
Yeah.
Did you see the part when Kane opened up the coffin thing and he looked for his brother, but his brother wasn't in there. So I guess Kane went back and then. I guess when he opened up the thing, his brother came out from the cast and not from under the stage.
Yeah,
I saw that one. It was one of like when I saw this match, I was like, whoa, because like, I forgot who it was. I think it was who was it? I think it was John Cena, and he was standing in the ring, and then everything went dark. And then all of a sudden, Kane looks in the coffin.
He opens. He kicks it with his foot. He walks back like 5 feet back, and then he looks back, and then he sees his brother right there. And then they start like going at it like crazy.
So I'm gonna tell you what happened at Money in the Bank. It was a six-man ladder match with Braun Strowman, Sami Zayn, and all of them. So all of them are hurt, right? They are down and all hurt. And then the eighth man was Sami Zayn, but I guess Braun Strowman got kicked out. So
really?
So Brock Lesnar attacked Sami Zayn and hung him up, came out, and then he was going to attack, but all of the men were hurt though. Wow. So he looked at it and he was like, man, I gotta get this and man. Then,
yeah.
He went up and then unstrapped it and then boom.
He just got him. Who do you guys think the best WWE superstar is?
Who do you think?
Did you see the match when when John Cena got hit, when John Cena got thrown in that light thing, and it, he oh, got yeah. sparkled, oh, yeah. he got sparkled
oh, yeah.
off.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And
that was funny. I was laughing at that
one. I know.
Big Show did, dude.
Yeah, when Big Show picked him up, pinned him in there, and then all of a sudden you could see he's sleeping in there, and then all of a sudden you could see the sparks going. I'm like, what are you here?
Yeah,
yeah, he almost like got yeah. caught. He almost like got caught on fire and stuff. I'm like, oh my God.
And then all of a sudden, I don't know why Brock Lesnar had to pick Sami Zayn, hang him up for no reason.
Do you think he did that?
Well, I think because he probably wanted his title back. So he's probably gonna come on Monday night and choose if he's going to fight Kofi Kingston for the WWE
oh, yeah.
or Seth Rollins for the WWE Universal Championship.
His map is he won the Universal Championship. He wants his title back.
If you could have any title, what would it have? Would you rather have the tag team, Universal Championship, WWE Championship? What would you rather have?
Universal Championship.
The tag team championship.
Tag team championship?
Yeah.
What would you want?
I would have the red one.
Oh, I know what you're
talking about. The universal.
The universal championship.
But there's a new title out now. It's called the 24/7 championship, and you can win like all you want. So like on Monday night, Mick Foley came out and he was just like introducing my new 24/7 championship, and then all of the superstars came out and they were fighting, and then Titus O'Neil came out and then he won that, and then right behind him Bobby Roode comes in and pins him, then 1, 2, 3 he keeps it, and then everybody like every superstar
did you see the people with all the white shirts and Triple H's wife told him to get out of the ring, but he didn't want to get out the ring.
Oh,
and
yeah.
He kept on
yeah.
saying yes, yeah. yes, yes, yes. I'm like, oh yeah. my word.
And then
his wife came like straight to the stage and like
Stephanie McMahon?
No, it was Triple H's wife.
Yeah, Stephanie McMahon.
Yeah, Stephanie McMahon. That's what
yeah, yeah. And then she told that the other guy that was standing in the middle of the stage with all the his people in the back, and she told him, Stephanie McMahon told him to get out the stage, and he didn't want to get out, so they had to call security on him.
Do you guys know what the Triple H stands for? I heard it stands for something, but all I remember is like Hunter or something.
It's whoa. Well, his real name is Hunter Hills Hounsley, but...
Yeah, that's what the Triple H is, Hunter Hills Hounsley.
Yeah, that's what Triple H is.
Yeah, Hunter Hills
Hounsley. Yeah. So, it's like, every time Braun Strowman gets mad, he just fights Sami Zayn for no reason when he gets mad.
Did you see the part when Braun Strowman picked up the ambulance truck and pushed it over, and then Brock Lesnar was...
I did see that.
When Brock Lesnar was in there, and he tried to push it over again to see if he would come out. Yeah, and did you see the part when Brock Lesnar hit broke that red caddy?
Oh.
When he tore it like straight apart, I'm like yeah.
Like it's like
and the two security guards were looking at him like he had like the security guards was looking at Brock Lesnar like he had two heads or something. I'm like,
oh, yeah.
Hey.
He was like he was like, what the heck is this guy doing in my car?
Yeah. How about
remember the part that Braun Strowman picked up Sami Zayn, put him in the trash thing, in the garbage truck, put him in the trash.
Remember when Braun Strowman he ripped Vince McMahon's door.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
and
then Vince
was like,
oh
yeah,
my God,
then,
why?
And then he hit it with the axe and then he tore up the driver's seat, the second seat, and he ripped it open with his hand and stuff.
Yeah.
And then he started slamming it with the jackhammer. He started slamming it with the axe, and then he broke all the glass in the back of the car.
That was Everything just shattered, like the whole place.
Yeah, the whole, it was all a mess. Like the windows were broken. The whole car was like a destroyed thing. Yeah.
Did you guys see the problem when he grabbed the car and flipped it over of Kevin Owens' car? Kevin Owens' car, he flipped it right over.
Yeah. What, the red caddy?
Yeah. No, Kevin Owens' car, like.
And then did you see when Brock Lesnar when Brock Lesnar told Triple H to come get his ATV out and then
I don't think I saw that one.
You didn't see that one?
You didn't see the part when
Brock Lesnar told to get Triple H to come out here to get his ATV and then Triple H came out there and drove his ATV away.
Oh yeah, I remember.
I guess the next show I seen was when Brock Lesnar had a motorcycle and then he had to tell Triple H to come get it too.
Oh yeah.
I seen that.
Do you guys like playing the WWE game? Oh yeah, it's fun.
I don't really have any of those games. I have my cousin. He has those games.
Yeah. My brother, he just plays it 24/7. Like, he doesn't even stop.
I play Grand Theft Auto 24/7.
That game is fun.
I can never get off of that game.
Me?
Really?
Like, me, when I go home and play WWE, I'll never get off of it.
Why?
Because I love playing my games.
Too much fun. That's why.
We all like to come home after school and play our games, I guess.
I know. Like, me, I'm Fortnite all day.
Me, I'm Apex all night.
Guys, we'll be taking a 5-minute break because the Wi-Fi is kind of slowed down. So we'll be taking a 5-minute break and we'll be back, okay?
Yep. Got it.
Please do not leave, guys, and we will be coming in shortly. Give me just like 5 to 10 minutes and we'll be coming back. Please stay tuned. Right.
Let me do it.
Sorry, guys. We are back. But the Wi-Fi was going down a little bit, but now we are back and hopefully you guys are still here tuning in. So we are all tuning in.
Yeah,
so
hopefully it won't crash again.
Hopefully it won't crash again.
Yeah, I hope not.
What I want to talk about is before he came here, me and Jack had a little 1-on-1 in NBA 2K19, and you could say he beat me. I mean, 22-30
mm-hmm. by 9 points.
Even though Jack got nine points.
I was up by like 10 points.
I liked how the part when you tried to shoot that 3 and you missed. It kept on going back.
Yeah, we kept on missing shot after shot.
I was in the corner, knee all the way down, a fast break, and he just, hey, I go late. Bam, it's full. Kyrie misses it.
because you didn't make a great pull up three.
I was coming back though in that Adam dunk by Thompson.
No. He was like boom.
Jack, I know you made a good three though.
If we do a rematch, I'll beat you again.
Yeah, right, Jack.
I will.
Really?
You could be Curry. I'll be Kyrie. I'll still destroy you.
Dude, Kyrie is one of like the top 10 NBA complainers because A, he does not care like about his own team. He only cares about himself. And B, all he does is just shows up and shows
Kyrie
off.
Kyrie does that?
Yeah. Curry though, the Warriors have won 6 championships. Curry broke Kobe Bryant's record with the most threes.
But Curry's not better than Kobe Bryant.
Yeah, he is.
Curry can shoot from anywhere
around the court.
Curry is not better than Kobe. Kobe is.
Who do you think?
It goes Michael Jordan, Kobe, and then it goes LeBron.
Are you saying that Stephen Curry ain't better than all of them? Because the last few games I've seen, I think Curry's the most better.
Steph Curry is better than all of them.
You gotta think about it because back then, Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant were going up against like back then people, like the older people. You know, they play better defense than now.
Dude,
and nowadays all like the rookies. And
MJ
stuff.
was the best basketball player that ever lived. But now
Kobe,
we
Kobe respect.
Yeah, him too. But But those you fans out there, who do you think who is a better 3-point shooter in
Kyrie or
in
Curry?
The NBA?
I think Curry. Personally, I think Curry's a better 3-point shooter.
Yeah, I think Curry is.
I think.
I think Kyrie is a better ball handler.
No, he's not.
Yes, it is.
No.
Yes, it is.
Steph Curry's way better than the Celtics.
I don't think. Who won two-time MVP?
People are saying
that
they're going to the Warriors.
People are saying that that it goes Allen Iverson and then it goes Kyrie and then Curry for the ball handling.
You know what your brother likes? He likes the Red Sox. He likes the Yankees, but he don't like the Red Sox.
Yeah, go Yankees!
I'm gonna tell you this right now, Ma. You think that the Yankees are gonna win this year? You're lucky that the Red Sox are on this year, because guess what? They might win the Yankees this year. They might win all the teams this year, and they might win another World Series championship.
Damien, listen to this. Yankees is gonna win the Red Sox because your team's gonna lose, okay?
I don't think what he's talking about ain't gonna be true, because I think the Red Sox is gonna win this year again.
Oh yeah, Damien. You like the Red Sox, we like the Yankees. So we're gonna win you, Damien. Yeah. We're gonna win you and your team. So what are you gonna say about that?
How'd you like when the Red Sox beat the Dodgers at Dodger Stadium and they won that whole series? Because you know why? Because the Red Sox are nasty and they're gonna do good this year and they're gonna win again.
Oh yeah, what happened to?
See, if you're such a big Red Sox fan, can you name one person on the team?
Yeah.
Mookie Betts.
Name one more.
Xander Bogaerts.
Like,
exactly, because I watch baseball every day.
I watch UFC.
You should get it on TV. You should get the Nesson app.
The Red Sox?
The Nesson app.
The Nesson app?
Yeah.
How about this?
What?
I have the NBA app. That's what I do.
Hey.
Oh, NBA you don't app. Have that. You don't have the Nesson app. You only have the NBA app.
How about this? The Red Sox. What happened to the Red Sox a long time ago? They lost.
Because they didn't do good.
They didn't do good last year. That's why they lost. They're off to a bad start right now.
Yeah.
But they're doing better.
I think the Yankees still have a chance of winning this year.
I know they could win.
They could win this year, but we'll have to see about the Red Sox though.
I don't know.
Yeah. Okay. So, Kyrie Irving, right? The Boston Celtics said that they would do a lot better without Kyrie because he's a show off. He only cares about himself.
But the Golden State also said they'll do better without Kevin Durant.
Yeah, but guess what? Kyrie Irving is leaving the Celtics anyway, so there's no point.
What team do you guys think Kyrie Irving is going to be going to? I personally think he's either going to the Nets or the Pistons.
No, he's probably going to the
Clippers or Detroit Pistons.
Yeah.
My dad said he might go to New York Knicks though.
The New York Knicks. If he goes to the New York Knicks, KD. That'd be crazy.
Yeah, then if he goes to the New York Knicks, then who we gonna have as a backup?
I don't know. Do you think Stephen Curry will ever leave Golden State?
Ever. Because the Red Sox need him.
Without Curry, they go say none. Well, I can't say that. They still got Draymond. Hey, they got Andre Iguodala. They got.
Guess what? If Kyrie leaves the Celtics, then who we gonna? I don't know. I think if Kyrie Irving leaves the Celtics, and I think Curry might have a chance being with the Celtics though.
Kyrie will not even leave. You know what they might do?
What?
You know what I just thought? This is probably the most stupidest idea but I ever thought of.
Oh my god.
I'm probably gonna get mad at me for this. This is really dumb to me, dude. Imagine they make Jason Tatum point guard for the Celtics and then get Kevin Durant and make him the small forward.
That would never happen. I'm just saying though.
If that did happen, that'd be crazy.
The Warriors are the defending NBA champ champions be because A, they won the championship 6 times in a row. But
that's right.
B, because they only lost one time against Cleveland, but the year after though, Golden State won, and last year they won again.
I'm saying I got no hate on Curry. Curry is like one of my like top three favorite players of all time. It goes maybe Kobe. It's because the reason I don't say Michael Jordan is in my top three because I wasn't around at this time, so I didn't see a play, but I know he was really amazing. So mine goes Kobe Bryant, then it goes Kyrie, and then Curry.
Mine is Curry first, and then second, either Kyrie or Kevin Durant.
Oh, you said Kevin Durant. Then, no, nope. I'm done.
And then
Kevin Durant's a snake.
What'd you say about
Kevin Durant's a snake?
Kevin Durant is not a snake.
No, Kevin Durant is not a snake.
Then Kyrie.
Kevin Durant is not a snake. He's good. Kevin Durant is a really good bad player. He's amazing at what he does. But the reason I'm saying snake is because all he did, he left Oklahoma City Thunder with Russell Westbrook just because Russell Westbrook, he says Russell Westbrook wasn't good enough for him to get an NBA Finals. So he had to leave that team to Oklahoma, and he had to go to the best team in NBA just to get a ring. That's what he did.
You know how
he knew he couldn't get a ring by himself. You know he can't do that. Unlike Kyrie or LeBron or somebody like
that. Did you see MVP too? Because it was Curry and now Durant.
How many MVPs did Kevin Durant win when he's on Oklahoma? He couldn't because he can't do it by himself.
I think zero.
Exactly. He can't zero. Do it by himself. He needs Curry. He needs Klay. He needs all these type of people.
Iguodala.
What do you feel about DeMarcus Cousins?
He never makes 3-point shots.
What?
That was a pretty good matchup because Cousins
was
like,
so overpowered though. Because like Golden State's an all-star team.
In Draymond too because he's all like everywhere. Yo, he was a big dog on the court against Portland 117-119. Won by 2 points and then they were having their victory dance, and now they're off to their fifth straight NBA Finals season.
Wait, Curry doesn't average the most points though, right?
Yeah.
He doesn't average the most points.
Yes, he does.
He averages the most points in the NBA right now.
I think Stephen Curry makes the most points.
Who's your favorite center?
My center. I'll say Andre Iguodala.
Andre Iguodala?
Yeah.
Not center. He's a power forward. No, he's a small forward.
Oh yeah, my.
Come on, Jack. You can do better.
Mine of all time is, it's either between. It's hard. Center. I'm just trying to say who's my favorite. I would say of all time maybe Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and then right now, who would probably be. Maybe. Ooh, that's a hard one. I don't know. I keep thinking that Chris.
Why? It's not a hard. It's not a hard thing.
It's not even hard.
No, I know there's a lot, but who's my favorite? Because there's so many good centers.
Okay, if you could say everyone's your favorite, but you gotta pick.
Everyone.
DeMarcus Cousins.
Yeah. Why you like?
DeMarcus is my favorite center of all time. Center, not a like player. Kobe Bryant is my favorite of all time.
No,
player.
I like James.
James Harden is I'm good.
Yo, yeah, James
I like LeBron yeah. James. I like Kevin Durant.
Oh, I like Kevin Durant. I'm good. Kevin Durant's man. Awesome.
You know, I like Russell Westbrook.
Oh yeah,
I like him a lot.
I like LeBron James. I like. Kyrie Irving and I like Stephen Curry.
Yeah, me too.
Those are my three players. Those are the three players that I like.
Yeah.
Yeah. Jack, so tell everybody what you're trying to say about LeBron when he's in the Cavs. He played like a baby.
Okay,
I said that.
You said that? You say he played like a baby?
I said LeBron James plays like a baby.
Why did you play like a baby?
Okay, fans. I told Ty that LeBron James plays like a coward because all he does, he said, "Oh man, I wish blah 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 blah," and the Kyrie is like, "Man, oh man, LeBron though, like all he does, he thinks he's the man, and he jumps and does this and that." But
it's so funny because I have a little basketball hoop in my room, right?
I seen it when we came in your house.
That's right.
Me and my brother Vaughn, we always do like a little 3-point contest. Yeah. And of course, I always win.
Because you probably stand back up your room with the ladder and shoot that three from the ladder.
Hey, Curry for three.
Is it the man? Is it Beginich calls himself the man now? I don't know why. Who? Though. Beginich, the man. I don't know.
She's not the man. She's the woman.
I know woman.
She's
know.
The woman. I don't know about that.
Ooh,
you better watch out.
You better watch out, Daniel.
What if Becky Lynch is watching this right now?
What's she gonna do? Come in here and stop the show?
She's gonna slap you.
She's gonna suplex you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Hey, she wishes she's gonna do that because she ain't gonna do nothing.
Hey, Damien, Brock Lesnar was 2-5 you.
See that man who's sitting in that chair? Eric, who's sitting in that chair, will stop her from coming over here.
You think Eric does stuff? Eric, you better do.
You better leave that door closed so she won't come in here and mess up our show.
Like, the man.
Yeah, she thinks. She thinks. Yeah, she thinks she's the man. She's
the man.
You think she's the best diva right now?
Hey, I don't know. I have no idea.
There is another type of people who watches WWE Divas just for the looks.
Oh, I know.
No, not really. You know what? I only watch WWE because it's fun and I like to see all the wrestling fights.
Hey, guys.
The girls, like.
Ty.
No.
Yeah. Especially
all right, how about the girls.
Jack, I don't know why you're saying the girls, but you like them too.
Yeah, girls.
Exactly, man.
Hey, exactly.
Wait.
Man.
Yeah,
exactly.
How about Natalia, the diva?
Oh, she sucks.
she sucks.
I like Nikki Bella.
Why do you like Brie Bella?
I don't like Brie Bella.
You can look, but you can't touch.
Yeah, you wish I can't touch.
You can't touch.
I got one. How about
Bell.
Nia Jax.
No, not Bell. Only Nikki Bella.
How about Nia Jax?
Remember that song we were listening to in the car by
Ariana Grande?
Yeah, Ariana Grande.
I forgot what it was called. It was like, maybe Javi.
Javi, you know that song?
Bro, what's your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
What's your girlfriend? Yeah.
Hey,
Ariana's a boy.
Yo, he looked at me, he was like, what is this?
I'm like, what kind of song is this?
And all of a sudden, he's like,
I'm like, all kind of, I'm like dancing and stuff because I don't know what the song is. I'm like bumping to it and stuff. I'm like, oh yeah, good, great, great song.
You're like, whoop.
If we had Post Malone in the car, it would be a posty.
Oh
fest.
Yeah, it would.
Yeah,
Post Malone.
With sunflower.
How about a mama calls you on TV.
I think all the fans are like, can you guys please stop singing? You guys are not good.
Why do you have pain on your wrist? Queen, don't stop me.
Ty.
Right there. You should wipe that off.
It's a scar.
Imagine.
What you were saying?
How can a pen be a scar? You do that.
No, I don't.
If you like this.
Hey, that's not a scar though. This is a scar.
Where?
Right there.
Oh yeah, that's
car.
I got a scar.
That's a needle scar. That is not no pen scar, homie.
Oh wait, Jack. What you were saying?
Yeah, so, it's not a pen scar. So it's a
yo, Darren.
A shot. What?
Alright.
Okay,
Jack.
So for the band Queen, him and I love from them this. I'm sounding like Don't stop me. Hey.
And have one like
you know the rhyme? Galileo.
Radio Gaga. Radio Gugu.
Here we go.
Radio Gaga. All we hear is Radio Gaga. Radio Gugu. Radio Gaga.
I gotta say, they listen to the song mostly every day in the morning. I can't believe they listen.
School practice.
They practice for shows in school. They practice for everything. I'm like, oh my word.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh yeah.
If you ever came to my school and you seen your brother, you would know how they get down on Queen.
Hey, how about you? You watching like bandpipes or something?
What?
Bandpipes.
Yeah.
Bandpipes. What do you mean?
I think I'm gonna go home and take a nap and then play some Grand Theft Auto
Why don't you play some Fortnite?
No, I play Apex, man.
Oh, Apex. Yo, give me that. Love you, my dude.
Hey yo,
I just downloaded it last week.
Yo, I'm already level like 30 in it.
Yo, some people are already level like 150. I'm like, I didn't even get that far yet, and you're already still farther than me.
I'm only level 30, and you're like mad high.
No way.
You hear about the new character Octane? The new character Octane, Mirage, and
Yeah, the only ones that are unlocked is the girl with the red hair, the girl that flies, the guy that does something else, and then I know there's all different kinds of people.
My favorite is I always mess up his name. It's like Gibraltar or Gibraltar.
I don't know. It's something like that. And then it's a guy where he wears a mask and he has a little hawk. So when you first pick him,
he's a male character, right?
Yeah, he's a male character.
He
has a hawk on his arm, and then once you first start a match, you see it fly off.
Hey, Ty. So in NBA 2K19, when you do a my career mode, who do you think you would probably draft your play in?
I'd probably draft. That's hard. Well, my first player. Wait, the first person I'd draft, I'd get LeBron.
Oh really?
How is it hard?
Steph Curry.
Because there's so many different players. It's like.
No, there's all kinds of different players and all kinds of different teams, though.
Yeah, exactly.
There's 30 teams in NBA with 13 players on each one. So if you do that, that's 30 times 10. I mean, 30 times 13. And I'm not doing my math right now.
Yeah,
why
not?
30, 60, 90, 120, 150, 180, 210, 240, 270, 300, 330, 360,
290.
How did you get all that math in your head?
I don't know. So that's 390... 39 pages in NBA right now.
Okay, so.
Oh my god.
Woo!
So, for right now, who do you think, fans, who do you think the best 3-point NBA star is?
I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna go. You know who I'm gonna go with since you're Mr. Golden State boy?
Yo.
I'm gonna go with Mr. Curry.
Mr. Curry.
He thinks he's the three-pointer man.
I usually play Micah for my team.
Oh really?
My dude, he's a 92 overall shot creating post score.
Jack's mom's there.
Not here. I know it. I got home.
Shout out to Jack's mom.
Jack's mom right there.
Yeah, so, but if we get the rematch, all I'm saying is I'm gonna break your ankle.
Dude, I will cross you up so bad. You'll be like, oh my god, it's lost.
I'm going easy on you.
Yeah, right, dude. I kept on stealing the ball every time.
I bet if you
bad passes, man.
Ty, I bet if Jack versus you, Jack will break your ankles in like 5 seconds.
Oh yeah, five seconds.
Yeah, it would.
Whenever I verse you in NBA, I always beat you.
Oh yeah, what happened? I beat you, so I don't want you to talk. So be quiet.
I don't like. Be quiet. We went to we moved to 4 overtime.
Yeah.
How can you go to 4 overtime?
you just keep getting the same score, and whenever the time was
up, how can I? If I ever played basketball, I don't know how people can get the same exact score every time they shoot.
Because it's called like.
But there's a secret way though to turn all of the stats up.
The tendencies.
Yeah.
It's called the tendencies though.
It's called the CPU/user.
And then every shot you.
That's what me and you did. That's right. Why, that's how you can't make it on shot.
Just shoot it, boom.
Then Curry
with the shot.
Wow. It's like
Steph Curry. Oh, tell him the shot I made. I thought it was with. It was with
Okay, fans. Yeah. This Kitai, he was at the half court line. Yep. And he just shot the ball and then boom, it went out like Oh my god, it didn't even hit backboard.
You kept on getting mad because Jack kept on shooting those threes.
Yo, Ty, he said, come on.
He's sitting right here, like, damn it, this kid made a three and he like shot it right through my face.
Yeah, because I can't wait.
You just sat in the chair and looking all mad, like,
Kyrie was literally wide open every single time. You even know he was wide open every single time.
Yeah.
The tendencies were all the way up to 100%. And when it's on 100%, you're supposed to make it every single time, especially when you're open. He would be wide open.
I see
Curry too.
I see you making. I see you making a three. Hey. I see you making a three. You followed off. I see Jack making a three. You guys both followed all the shots off.
Yeah, we can't foul.
Because you got free throw.
He got free throws and he missed. I forgot it was James Harden.
I missed one.
Yeah. It was James Harden, but you kept on, and I see Jack. He kept on thinking he can. He told me in school that he can make a half shot court.
Half shot court.
Dude, half shot court.
last year in the basketball game, I was just sitting there. I just shot it and then swish. It went right in.
And you think I'm gonna believe you on that?
Yeah, oh,
it's
me too.
But you don't think because you don't even know what it's like to be an NBA athlete.
Jack,
you're a liar.
You're a liar, Jack. Okay, you're a liar. You can't. You never can beat me at basketball games.
Dude, I'll cross you up so bad that you'll just punch me in the ball.
Jack. You better slow your roll, because I'm a better basketball player than you, because I watch more basketball games than you.
Hey, look who is talking, because I can shoot from mid range.
Yeah, I know you can. You can not shoot from mid range.
No, you can't.
I can just do.
Can you shoot from mid range?
Boom.
Yeah. My cousin can shoot from half range, but I don't think I can shoot. I don't think.
When I shoot, I'm nasty. I'm like.
I want to see you when you get back to your house, when you play something.
I think
Jack,
I want to see me and you playing your room and see if I can shoot a three from that little thing.
You're going home anyway.
If you first beat Stace in the low basketball court,
just go home.
You pack your bags and go home.
Because I'll be raining on you every time.
Yeah, why, buddy?
Yeah, that thing is so small. I don't think I can reach that thing.
So bad that you would be mad.
Oh, yeah? I'll bring some more Joes who put you to sleep.
I'll bring Roman Reigns in, and he could just, boom.
Jack, you're lucky Roman Reigns ain't here right now.
I don't care, dude. I'll just get up and just Superman punch him.
They got Braun Strowman, don't Slam you so hard that he did to Rey Mysterio.
Ooh. Dude, I'll give Brock Lesnar here. He can lift Nodum him BB because he's actually cool, but
Oh yeah? You think Brock Lesnar's bigger? How about Big Show? He's mad.
Wait,
he's retired.
Wait, Braun Strowman is bigger than Big Show. Though.
Oh no, they're both
than anyone.
They're monsters. Did you guys know that?
Yeah. And you know Brock Lesnar don't play for WWE anymore.
Oh. And
hi mom,
what's up mom?
What's Gucci?
Everybody,
oh my
god,
damn. it's just the word.
I told him I'll buy him a monster truck.
Gucci Asus.
Yeah, and I'll buy you a $5 and I'll buy you a how much was that Lamborghini you said you wanted?
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
That was like $800,000.
Yeah, you buy me that monster truck and I'll buy you that $8.
He means it too, man.
Green Lamborghini. I'm gonna get you any monster truck you want, okay?
You need to give me that.
Okay, fine.
I'll go to the dollar store and get you the 12.
I'm not giving you anything yet.
How about you go to Monster Jam?
I'm not giving you anything back.
How about you go to Monster Jam and you tell all the drivers to bring their trucks to my house and we can all park them in the parking lot.
How about that one?
Okay.
Okay, so you and me, right when it's the finals in 2K19. If you go up to me, I'll just cross
myself out. Boom, boom, boom. Big Show.
And then Curry
with
I'm clutch.
Did you see the part?
I'll just do it in my legs. I'll behind the back. I'll do a Euro step and go.
I'll just do boom, boom, boom. Then shot.
Oh, Michelle's on. Hi, Michelle. How you doing? Thank you for tuning in. And remember to tell us, who is your favorite basketball player? Who is your favorite WWE player?
And just for the last, and just say who's your favorite monster truck driver in the world.
Is pick what buster that you like. Just
because me and Jack over here are having an argument when he said most people are gonna pick Curry. I said most people are gonna pick Curry. So you guys picked.
I think Curry's better.
Yeah, better though because all he could do is just shoot and just rain threes all night, all day,
that
anywhere,
but
Curry, anytime.
But Curry could just cross people up and break people's ankles all
Kyrie's
day.
Curry's a ball hogger.
Listen, we all have to see who's better, but
yeah,
we're gonna see who's the best monster truck in the world finals to see who's really the monster truck best driver.
Hey, yeah.
I know you like monster trucks, me too, but who thinks who is gonna win?
It could be all of them. Who knows?
Can all of them even win?
All of them is gonna win.
Some monster trucks can win.
It needs to be one winner.
I don't think so.
What's the name? Who's gonna win the monster truck?
There can be two contenders though.
What's their names?
you got me stuck on that one. I'll name you two. Max Steen and Gravedigger. Those are the two trucks I know. I know more about it. I forgot them.
They got the new Bakugan one too.
Well, so, I don't know, but they're two fast drivers. They're two good monster trucks, though. I like the wolf one and the dragon one.
How about the Scooby Doo one?
Yeah, they have Scooby. They have
Scooby Doo.
They have Scooby Doo one. They have a Scooby Doo truck too.
Oh my god!
Yo, would you want that?
What world are we in?
What do you think? What do you think I'm gonna drive that? No.
Yeah.
Wait, I probably would drive it if I probably would. Who knows?
You probably would, Darian.
Hey,
if you wanted to.
Hey, Darian.
Hey, who knows? I could probably ask one of the drivers to let me drive it around.
Hey, maybe.
You think you could do that?
Hey, Darian.
Hey, that you know how much power that those heavy monster trucks.
How much can they pull 1,000 ton?
You know how much?
Not 1,000, but I mean.
You know how much? Pounds. You know how much gas they use? 1,500 horsepower a day.
Wait, really?
That's
like $100 a tank.
They use 1,500. They use 1,500 horsepower.
The horsepower?
They can go. I seen pictures when they can fly so high in the sky, that they won't even, they break their trucks and everything.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They break
the wheels,
they break the body, Damien. They break the front, they break everything on their truck.
Damien.
They break. Whoa. They can mess up the dispenser in the truck, everything. You and know Damien. That. You can ding
them. I would never be able to do monster truck driving. That would be, that's just too Damien. Dairy.
And people can get mad hurt, too, while Damien. Driving it, too, if they're not safe.
One time I went go-kart driving.
Yeah,
that's the most I would do.
Oh my god, yo! Oh my god, I kept on getting hit in the back. I kept on getting rammed in the back, and they had to keep on helping me because no, I got rammed in the back.
I went to go kart driving, and all of a sudden, I go to turn, and I'm like, skrrr, because I thought I was
like skrrr.
I thought I was. Hey,
that's closing down. You know, you have to be 18 to drive those go karts inside inside the what mall?
What was it? I just went and I went like this, and the seatbelt was like around here, hit me right on my neck, and I'm like, and then my whole neck over here was like all swelled up.
Was
18 to drive a go kart?
Just like swelled.
It was bad.
Yeah, and in the mall that has round one in it, you only have to be 18 to drive those go karts in at that mall.
Wow. Round one is like has like a lot
of arcades.
A lot of arcades and bowling ball.
I wanted to show you guys something.
Bonnie
Addy. You got.
Yeah.
Let me see your medal.
So, look at that, people. Special Olympics medals, baby.
Oh, wait. You know what? Let's talk about... Look at
Javi. Yeah, look at Javi in the background throwing up those tubes.
Let's show them one by one.
Yeah, baby. Let's get it.
You got this one.
That's how we do it up in New Bedford High School. Hey. We show off.
Hey, all right, baby.
Let's talk about Special Olympics now.
And then you got this one.
What's your favorite...
You guys went to Special Olympics when
you should.
Yeah,
it was a couple
days ago, right?
Yeah, yeah. We went to Dartmouth High School, so we did so many.
What did you guys do there? Like,
we did all kinds of
we ran and did all kinds of
different obstacles.
Also, you guys did like 100-meter dash or something. Like
that thing was 100 meters. That thing was
you
a long, huh? So,
We were tired.
I was really tired.
So soon
as I left that school, I went there with my mom. After I left my mom's job, I went there and I took a nap. I crashed. I was done for the day. I'm like, oh my god.
Like, I didn't want to play on GTA.
I'm that tired and stuff. I want to like go home and lay down.
It's like we did like shot put, everything.
Shout out Lucas. Shout out Lucas. So getting back to WWE. I think if you could be any WWE character, like a superstar, who would you be?
I'll be Roman Reigns.
I'd be
Rey Mysterio because I feel like I could just jump off of anything.
Rey Mysterio is so small.
Oh yeah.
Me?
He's 5'11".
Me?
Or Rey.
Rey Mysterio is so small. Look at him.
Yeah, yeah. With a mask on too.
5'11", that's not that small.
Hey, like I want to be like Braun Strowman.
I
want to be Braun Strowman.
If you compare Rey Mysterio to all the wrestlers, Rey Mysterio is the smallest guy in the wrestling.
I have my tag partner, The Big Show.
He's dangerous,
and he will get him back.
I can hear you over there.
I hear you with the 619.
What?
619.
You can hear me,
dude.
Better?
If you spared me, I will get
who's
right back up.
Who's your favorite wrestler?
You want me just like slow motion?
I just told you.
Like,
oh yeah, Roman Reigns.
Like, yeah.
Braun Strowman is my favorite wrestler too.
You see how big he is though.
Braun Strowman?
Braun Strowman.
Oh, yeah.
He's a monster.
Yeah, like yeah, he's a big monster.
Monster among men he is.
Yeah.
I know. So, if you could choose any job in the entire world, what would it be?
A security guard.
NBA.
WWE Network.
WWE Network. That's not a job.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Well, you can control it, but don't you want to be in WWE, not WWE Network?
Yeah, I'm going to be in the WWE.
You
want to
be monster wrestling driver?
Yeah, I want to be. I can. If I NBA. Had, if any job, if it was, if yeah. I had any job in the world, it'd be two jobs: one at the mall and one driving monster truck.
Oh, nice.
So somebody said their favorite was Daniel Bryan.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah,
yes.
That's the part. That's the part.
No,
with
no,
Stephanie
no.
Be-
Ty,
that's the part when I told you about Stephanie McMahon told Daniel Bryan to get out the arena, but he wouldn't get out.
I like Daniel Bryan.
Did you see the part when Roman Reigns, when Stephanie McMahon smacked Roman Reigns in the face.
And then
Roman Reigns gave her a Superman punch in the face.
Oh, yeah, that was lit.
Hey, he went like this.
Like,
smack. Oh, she went, hey, boosh. Her hand went to Braun Strowman's face like this.
Did you guys like football, though?
Stephanie
McMahon
was like this to his face. Like,
so,
boom. Like, how?
Who's your favorite football team?
New England,
Seattle,
baby.
Seahawks.
New England Patriots.
Seattle, Seahawks,
Jack, if we ever face you in the if the Patriots ever face you in the Super Bowl, the Seahawks will never win.
You're lucky that New England won because A, they cheat.
B, how do they cheat?
Because you know why they cheated?
Every game, cheat. Every Super Bowl.
Jack, you know why the Patriots cheat? Because that time when they cheated, the ball was deflated. That's why they cheated.
Because their live receiver is a big, huge coward in a savage, too.
Jack,
he just catches the ball and just gets tackled.
But I feel like the Patriots got the ball this Super Bowl. The Patriots got the ball at halftime, and that's why they won. But I think
we played the Jacksonville Jaguars that day in our stadium, and we almost lost that because they almost won that game.
Yeah, my favorite team.
I know they almost won that.
My favorite team is of course the 49ers.
We have a
49ers. Ty, the 49ers is amazing.
Seattle 49ers
is the best.
You know what? I hate when we faced the Philadelphia Eagles and they won that game.
Bro,
I hated
they
that.
They did good.
No, they didn't do good. We lost that game because they played good. They wanted to party too early.
I know they want to party too early.
I thought they were a fourth quarter team.
I think the New England Patriots.
I thought they were a fourth quarter team, but what happened, huh?
They were a fourth quarter team.
Yeah.
What happened?
Wait. But did the Patriots lose in the fourth quarter? Huh?
Yes.
Oh. Yeah.
Because the Eagles are trash.
Who won that game?
But guess what, I still have respect for the Eagles.
One more thing
for
you.
I got respect for the Patriots.
Hey Jack.
Yeah, same too here.
Hey Jack.
But I feel like if Tom Brady leaves the Patriots would be nothing.
No, Jack.
They have no backup quarterback. They got a trash backup quarterback.
If Tom Brady ever leaves the Patriots, guess what? They would have somebody else from a different team, like the Eagles, someone from the Buffalo team.
Yeah.
Hey, Darren, the Buffalo team for no reason.
Who knows if Curry got drafted and traded to the Celtics and
Tatum took Curry's place, who do you think who would do better?
That'd be so bad.
You know, I think if Kyrie Irving leaves the Celtics, the Celtics gonna be nothing.
We need Curry.
Yeah, the Celtics.
Ty, if Kyrie Irving leaves the Celtics,
have been done ever since game two.
I don't care. They stink. They're not good.
Let me say.
Celtics have been out of the playoffs for a while, and I'm so bad about that. So stupid.
Hey, you know what? I think if Kyrie Irving ever leaves the Celtics will not be nothing at all. They won't be nothing at all.
Who's going to the NBA finals?
I said if Kyrie Irving leaves the Celtics won't be nothing.
And when Tom Brady leaves the Patriots will be so trash because all they will have is Edelman. Because Gronkowski already left because he's going to WWE. And if Tom Brady leaves,
Gronkowski's going to WWE.
You didn't know that?
WWE. No.
Did you? Do you remember in the WrestleMania when Gronkowski came out of the stadium and they came down and went into the ring and tackled I think it was Triple H.
No, I didn't even see.
I watched.
Wait, guys.
Gronkowski already signed a contract with Triple H to go into the WWE. He left NFL already.
But I never seen Triple H. I never seen Gronkowski in a match.
He's gonna
with nobody.
He was already in the WrestleMania, but he's gonna be coming back.
He was at the
But I didn't see him in WWE though.
He's gonna be going to WWE.
He should have done like Ronda Rousey did. You know what he should have done? Ronda Rousey got beat up for a championship match and got crying.
Wait, hey, soft. Hey, you know what?
Wait,
you know what? I think Gronkowski should have stayed with the Patriots. Yeah, and would not. And I think. Oh, I think he would have just stayed.
What if Ronda Rousey came in right now
and bopped you in the head, man? Hey, huh?
Because she.
What would you do?
But she is the baddest woman, like, the woman in the planet. Ronda Rousey.
No, you know what? I think Gronkowski should have just stayed with the Patriots and wouldn't go to the WWE.
Why would Ronda Rousey play for the Patriots, huh?
I'm saying Gronkowski should have stayed with the Patriots.
Ronda Rousey went to WWE because she is soft, and she couldn't take a punch into the face.
Exactly.
But you're soft. That's why she's a baby.
Her title away. They took away one time, and now she wants to be a little baby and wants to go to WWE.
Didn't I just tell you that she's a baby? Look, like, come on, man.
She is.
Hey.
Exactly.
Because
I know.
So why is she a baby if
she is one?
She is one.
Jack,
she's a big
baby. I just said that.
Yeah, she is.
Yeah.
I know she is.
You got me confused.
Ty, I'm getting all confused here.
Y'all get me confused.
Is that too, dude?
I'm getting confused.
Because she's getting beat up.
You probably all confused.
Curry fuse.
But she's gonna be up. She went to UFC. She lost like two times now. She went to WWE. Now she's getting mad again. She went to
UFC. You know what I think? The worst chance fight I ever saw in my entire life.
What?
CM Punk leaving WWE to go to UFC, and he was the.
CM Punk is the top ten.
He wasn't one of the worst. He was the worst UFC fighter in history.
He was like this.
CM Punk was the Best WWE superstar on Raw.
But then he became the worst UFC fighter of all time. You know how small
CM Punk is. He's like a little midget.
I know, right? Yeah.
Wait. And then. Oh,
exactly. Compared to CM Punk to Rey Mysterio. Look at them two. Those two look like midget brothers.
Yeah.
I know.
Like. All of a sudden, when he went to UFC, all of a sudden he went, like, tap out for no reason. Like, tap
Why
out.
Why did he do that?
Like, wait, like, he went.
Wait,
like,
oh, yeah,
I,
yeah.
I saw him.
It's like he went like this. He went, stop.
I saw him. Stop.
Hey, did you see the part when, when Stephanie McMahon's dad had to get something in his eye because he lost an eyeglass?
And then
Roman Reigns started to tackle him, and after the three, they sent a new referee in. Roman Reigns got so mad because Stephanie McMahon's dad had something wrong, and then he said,
he's like, I need a
new referee.
I know. And I saw CM Punk, he's in the practice facility.
Yeah,
and UFC, I know. And he, all of a sudden, he's getting Lee choked out by,
His opponent.
His opponent.
Chris Jericho. Or
how trash can you be to get that like?
Remember the Shield in the Wyatt family first met in the ring. The Shield in the Wyatt family. CM Punk. He was doing the icon device, and then Dean Ambrose was. He was like, no, I can't quit. No, I know.
Hey, did you see the part when Stephanie McMahon's dad got up, and then Roman Reigns got up after he got hurt, and then he looked at Roman Reigns looked at Stephanie McMahon's dad, and Roman Reigns went like this. Stephanie McMahon's dad, and then they had to get a new wrestler, referee.
What's your favorite WrestleMania thing?
Roman Reigns was still on the plat, and then all of a sudden they start bringing like more wrestlers out and stuff, and they all started like fighting each other.
So I think. It's time to go, guys.
Yep.
And we actually went,
It's not time to go.
I think we got more time.
Yeah.
So, with WWE, so my favorite WrestleMania thing is when the, mine is the new WrestleMania. What?
Wait, what?
What happened?
The songs in the place, you have to take the headphones off.
Okay. Oh. Okay. All right. Peace out, guys.
No, not yet.
We'll be back.
Oh.
Dude,
it's not done yet, guys. We're going to be playing the little clip for you guys. My new song coming out. It's be coming out very soon. Yeah. Okay?
Wait, do we take these headphones off?
Yeah.
All right.
Take them out, guys. Guys, come on. Stand up and dance with us.
Hey.
Stand up. No. Yeah, stand up, man.
Dance,
y'all, come on!
I don't
know how to
dance, really? Fuck
y'all. Look at Jack
Chan
into it!
Oh, hey!
She's scared. That kind of move is there! Oh, look at it, I'll play basketball, you like basketball? Look at it.
Yeah, I love you.
They're gonna be tired.
Just check it out.
Check it out on Facebook and anywhere.
Anywhere.
Thank you guys,
and
have a great
day. And even on YouTube.
Yes. Even on YouTube. Don't forget to subscribe.
Don't forget.
All right. Thank you guys so much for coming.
Thank you guys so much. Have a really nice day. Hopefully you guys liked our show.
Thank you. That's it. That's our show.
Go home and stay tuned.
Woo! Celtics!
One more thing.